Did you know that smartphones, computers, lasers, MRIs, and GPSs all rely on quantum mechanics? Quantum mechanics is counterintuitive for beginners. If it doesn't sit well with you, you're in good company. Einstein didn't like it either. So why does quantum mechanics bend beginner brains into pretzels? Well, electrons, protons, neutrons, photons, the particles of light, Higgs bosons, and other small objects have been found to exhibit both particle-like and wave-like properties. Whether you see one behavior or the other in a physics lab depends on which kind of experiment you do. People like to make a big deal about the dissonance, referring to it as particle-wave duality. How can something like an electron move around like a particle and also interfere and diffract like a wave? Yet in nature, perhaps impertinently, the electron does precisely that. It has these dual features merely by existing, whether we humans are comfortable with it or not. Physicists like to call the electron a wave packet or a quantum. To help explain this quantum duality business, I like to use an analogy to humans like me with non-binary gender. I have feminine aspects and I have masculine aspects. As folks like us know from our years of lived experience, it is entirely possible to have both femininity and masculinity in one whole human being. Which behaviors you see in me will depend on which context you put me in with which people. Just as electrons may look particle-like in one experiment and wave-like in another. That is not a contradiction or a hot mess of confusion. For either of us, it is just complex, nuanced behavior. You could make a big deal out of my non-binary nature and say that I have feminine-masculine duality, or you could just get over it and be cool with my existence in the universe. The same goes for particle-wave duality in quantum mechanics. It's not hard to understand if you're willing to just stretch your imagination a bit further than it was used to stretching. Every student of quantum mechanics has to do this intellectual labor, and it can take a while before it feels natural. Just like with emotional labor and non-normative genders. The key thing is to make a continuing commitment to listening and learning. This has been a presentation from non-binary U of T physics professor, A.W. Peet.